Welcome to another NBA Insider video. Today's topic is about something that can change the league as we know it. If you're up to date with news revolving around the NBA, then you'd probably already know that I'm talking about the so-called four-point line.
No! God! No! God! Please! No! 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 No!
Alright, jeez, calm down. Now, before any of you guys get upset about this and begin starting to take shots at Stephen Curry and other great shooters in the league, take a breather, because none of this has been confirmed. As a matter of fact, it looks like a rumor that is going around the association. But just to give you a better idea of what I'm talking about, I'll tell you what the so-called four-point line is. It's basically a further three-point line with an additional point added. That's it, plain and simple. They are also in talks for the expansion of the size of courts, basically to make sense of the idea of a four-point line. Personally, I don't think it's something that will happen, but hey, even the three-point line we currently have hasn't always been around. The three-point line first appeared in the ABA, or the American Basketball Association, in 1967. In 1979, the NBA finally adopted the line, putting it between 22 and 23 feet and 9 inches from the basket. Even the NCAA didn't officially add the three-pointer until 1986, with high schools doing so a year later. People thought that was a dumb thing to do, and now we're so used to it that it feels like it's always been there. So I mean,
anything's possible! Anything's possible!
According to ESPN, NBA directors have actually considered adding a four-point line. NBA President of Basketball Operations Rod Thorn spoke in a recent interview with ESPN and said that the league has considered expanding the size of the court and the introduction of a four-point shot. The NBA has had a 94 by 50 foot with a two-point max court system since the 1940s until the introduction of the three-point line in the late 70s. But many people believe that the growing size and increased athleticism of players in today's NBA requires the discussion of expanding the playing surface as well as the distance of some shots. An example of some of these players include DeMarcus Cousins, Karl Anthony Towns, and let's not forget about 7'3" Kristaps. If you're wondering what this has to do with anything, it's just to show that even big men in the league are slowly adjusting to the current gameplay style of the NBA, which is mostly being able to shoot outside the perimeter. The whole idea of a four-point line was first brought to discussion when many people complained that the current three-point line was too close and that it should be pushed further, probably due to the wild gameplay style of Stephen Curry and his miraculous shooting ability. But that's debatable. Even Dallas Mavericks owner Mark Cuban recently suggested that the NBA should look into making the three-point shot deeper. It's getting too close. Guys are shooting a foot behind it anyways. That's something we should look at. Cuban doesn't believe that the number of shots would decline, but rather that it would reward skill and open up the court some more. Cuban thinks a deeper three-point line could lead to more drives. I believe if a three-point line was pushed back or a four-point line introduced, there would be a decrease in attempts made outside. The last time the NBA moved the three-point line back, there was a big decrease in three-point attempts. After that decrease in attempts, however, the percentage of three-point attempts increased every season until the current one. This season alone, 28% of all shots have been from the three-point range. So I mean, there's still a possibility of it happening. However, while the league is still only in talks of the matter, there has already been some key people discussing the idea, including two of the NBA's greatest shooters, Reggie Miller and Larry Bird. Miller says it's comical. The league will be a laughingstock, and that will be in front of the line laughing the loudest. Why are we always trying to change and adjust the game? Yes, Reggie Miller thinks that changing and adjusting are bad. That's coming from one of the greats himself. He then goes on to say, no one else has that kind of range. Maybe Damian Lillard? Even Kyle Korver doesn't have this kind of range, and he's a great three-point shooter. If there were 10 guys doing what Curry can do, then we could talk about it. But even then, it feels like it could become a pinball machine. Add a four-point play, then a half-court shot. I just think a four-pointer would be a gimmick. Larry Bird, on the other hand, had open thoughts on the four-pointer. When I played, I never did practice three-point shots, but these kids here, that's all they do. The game has changed, no question about it. Every 10, 12, 15 years, there's something new coming in. You put that four-point line in there and people will start practicing. And once they start practicing, they get better at it. Maybe 5 or 10 years down the road, fours are what everybody will be shooting. The game evolves. Now you're probably also wondering who this would benefit. Before you jump to conclusions and say the Golden State Warriors, even Steve Kerr says a 4-point line sounds insane. I mean, if Kerr rejected the idea of a rule change that would give the Warriors such a huge advantage over the rest of the league, you have to believe it's not befitting one team at all. After all, he is the coach with the best shooter of all time.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my god. Stop fucking lying.
When it comes to talks of a possible four-point line, it only makes sense for Stephen Curry's name to pop up. According to data from NBA.com, Curry shot a ridiculous 46.7% on 21 for 45 shots from 30 plus feet, including a memorable 37-foot bomb from just inside the half court to beat the Thunder in overtime. That shot is shown in the thumbnail of this video if you missed it. Regardless of how far they push the line, even if it's a 5, 6, or a 7-point line, there is no changing Stephen Curry's ability to shoot. This chart shows Curry shooting from 30 plus feet compared to other all-stars and players who attempted his shots from that distance in this season. So as a matter of fact, it would probably hurt Curry rather than help him, because as the shots get further, the chance of it going in decreases, regardless of who you are.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man? Bro, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
But that's just my opinion. Now, despite all this hype around Stephen Curry and his shooting ability, there are still players who shouldn't shoot, who are already shooting. The Houston Rockets took the second most 3-point attempts this season, yet were 19th in 3-point percentage. If there's a value in a 4-point shot, teams would shoot them. If they can't shoot them at a high enough percentage, they won't. But eventually, as kids grow up with a 4-pointer the same way that Reggie Miller grew up with a 3-pointer, they will start adjusting to the shot. So why not throw in something that would be more entertaining for both players and fans? Just imagine any one of the league's greatest shooters hitting a 4-point shot while being fouled with the possibility of a 5-point play in the final seconds of a game. Just the thought of it is exciting. I know Golden State fans are hyped.
I am the one, the way your son don't need a gun to get respect up on the street.
In conclusion, I think the introduction of a 4-point line would be fun regardless of its con. I mean, in the end, that's what the NBA is meant for, to be enjoyed. Plus, this new potential 4-point line could change the NBA for better. I mean, had there been no introduction of a 3-point line, would Stephen Curry be the player he is today? I don't think so. For all we know, this might be something that could work for the best. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think about the NBA adding a 4-point line. Should they do it, or should they leave everything as is? If you enjoyed this video, feel free to show some love by leaving a like and subscribing. Also, if you have any thoughts and or recommendations for future videos, feel free to leave them down in the comment section below. Until next time, this has been another segment of NBA Insider. Thanks for watching.